Ladies and gentlemen, my name is TotalBiscuit. This is the sort of video I don't enjoy doing, as you're probably aware. However, these sort of things are necessary. It cannot become normalized. It cannot become acceptable for this sort of abuse to occur. And in the environment of YouTube, where getting help from Google is a shot in the dark at best, smaller channels affected by this sort of abuse need to be stood up for. They need to be given something of a voice, because it's very easy for these channels to be bullied and silenced without any real way to get the message out and any way to fight back. So the majority of the information in this video is taken from research, evidence, and screenshots by Sid Alpha, who originally created the video on this topic. The purpose of this video is essentially to amplify that message to make sure the person responsible does not get away with their terrible behavior. So to put a long story short, a composer by the name of Alex Mauer, I believe is the way that it's pronounced, was working on the soundtrack for a game called Star Mazer DSP. This person alleges that the developer of the game, Imago Softworks, did not pay for the soundtrack, did not pay this person what they were owed, and the response to that, which one would think would be take it up with the company, of course, what else would you do, was to yet again abuse the YouTube takedown system to issue copyright strikes against every single channel Alex could find that had any footage of Star Mazer DSP with any of the music in it whatsoever. This was a manual process, by the way. This was not a content ID match. That would be because, according to the evidence presented, Alex doesn't actually own the copyright to this music. Alex was working as a contractor, and part of said contract, which you can see on the screen right now, as provided by Imago Softworks, very clearly indicates that the rights are transferred to Imago Softworks, that this copyright does not belong to Alex. Now, this very clearly is an internal dispute between a contractor and a game developer. This is the sort of thing that should be sorted out, usually in private, if that doesn't work, through arbitration or in a courtroom if necessary. This should have nothing to do with any of the YouTubers who I wouldn't even call caught in the crossfire, because that indicates a lack of malicious intent. That indicates that there was a battle going on between two entities and some people got caught in the middle of it. They weren't caught in the middle of anything. These are manual copyright strikes, takedowns, specifically issued by this person for the sole purpose of trying to, quote, raise awareness of the situation and essentially try to pressure Imago Softworks by telling these people, you have to go and email them. This is their problem. Well, no, it's not, because they didn't issue these copyright takedowns. Alex Mauer issued these copyright takedowns. Alex Mauer is directly responsible for doing so. Now, if YouTube actually used the DMCA in the way that it's properly written, then the penalty for issuing a DMCA claim that you know is false is perjury, which is a fairly damn serious crime. However, YouTube's implementation of the DMCA is not actually an official implementation. As a direct result, they don't really have to follow those rules. They use the DMCA as a guideline. It's something that we came across a few years ago. I've dealt with false DMCA strikes before, and the people that I've dealt with could very well have been guilty of perjury were it an actual DMCA takedown. But it's not. It's modeled after the DMCA. So, are there any consequences for doing it? Well, no. Not unless somebody happened to take this person to court. The option for these channels is to counterclaim. The reality of it is, of course, that with a process like this, there should be some goddamn human oversight. I said this years ago, and yet this kind of nonsense keeps happening, because when someone is clearly, maliciously abusing a system like this, in the case of Alex, knowingly doing so, knowingly targeting innocent people, innocent channels, to further her own personal vendetta, attempting to turn these channels into crusaders, into pressure, essentially engaging in extortion when it comes to the dealings with these channels and this company. That is an abuse of the system. This is not protecting one's rights. These channels did no harm to you. They are completely innocent. This, we don't even have to get into debates of fair use and whether or not you actually have the right to do this. We don't know if you actually own this copyright. We don't know how valid that contract is. That's the sort of thing that would come up in a court of law. What we do know is that these channels did nothing wrong, did nothing to you, and yet you have punished them. You have then chosen to say, I refuse to revoke these strikes. On the basis of nothing whatsoever. It's pure maliciousness. This person has a seriously damaged moral compass. What they are doing is flat out unethical. Doing this threw away any possibility that a right-thinking individual could believe that Alex is the victim in this situation. I do not know who exactly is in the wrong when it comes to the copyright dispute between Alex and Imago Softworks. What I do know for certain is that these YouTubers had no part in it whatsoever, and that is indefensible. That's being a bully. Trying to use them as a conduit to apply pressure to the developer is outright ridiculous. There is a legal principle called equity, as you might be aware, the concept of an equitable agreement between people. There's one specific key tenet of that, and that is you must, when seeking equity, come with clean hands. That means that if you are seeking a remedy to a perceived wrong, you must not have done wrong yourself in the process of doing so. If this is an actual legal dispute, which Alex in a Steam post claimed that it was, claiming that Imago Softworks was going after her with a lawyer, then doing this has essentially torpedoed your case. This is evidence of wrongdoing on your part, of malice, of behavior that has no justification whatsoever. You're not protecting your rights, assuming that you had them to begin with, which is in question. What you are doing is violating the rights of other people, solely due to your vendetta. There is no sympathy to be had in that regard. I've seen people like this before. I've dealt with people like this before. People that play the victim, people that do wrong, people that act unethically, people that bully and abuse and lie and cheat, and yet attempt to make out as if they're the ones being targeted, that they're the ones who require sympathy and defense. Well, if you want sympathy and defense, don't engage in abusive behavior. Don't engage in dishonest behavior. Don't complain when people direct their complaints to you after you were the one who issued the strikes. Don't say, oh, well, I don't feel like reversing anybody's DMCA strike. Direct your complaints to the developer. The developer can't do anything about the strikes. They didn't issue them in the first place. Saying you are no longer willing to offer the possibility of having your DMCA strikes reversed, what the hell do you think you're doing? Who do you think you are? Exactly. What right do you believe? You know what you have done is wrong, and yet you double down and insist on doing it anyway. And you expect sympathy? Well, here's the problem. You are not the big fish in this particular situation. No, people will not sit idly by while you commit this sort of abuse. No, you can't go after tiny channels without one of us taking notice and rightfully and with full justification saying, no, this is wrong. Needless to say, I've contacted those that I know at YouTube Gaming to attempt to get these strikes reversed. I would like to extend the offer to anybody that has been affected by these strikes. Please get in touch with me via the email address that's on the screen right now. Provide me evidence and screenshots that you have received a strike on a Star Mazer related video, and I will forward that onto YouTube and see what I can do about it. This is unjustifiable abuse, and it will not be tolerated. This shouldn't even be a possibility. This shouldn't even be the kind of thing that can happen. Somebody should not be able to run around issuing copyright strikes against channels and potentially ruining the livelihoods of innocent people over a private dispute between themselves and a company. There should be some sort of manual oversight. You would think that something within YouTube would trigger. It's like, oh, there's a bunch of copyright strikes and this person who's never issued one before. Maybe we should have somebody human look at this and see if they actually own the rights to do it, or if what they're doing is even remotely justifiable. The fact that there isn't, that safeguard is not in place, is ludicrous, and you can't invoke the DMCA saying that you must comply with DMCA requests when in reality the YouTube copyright takedown system is not an official DMCA request. There must be consequences for these sort of actions, which means that this awareness must be raised. The industry must be made aware of this despicable behavior. They must be made aware that the person responsible for it is capable of such things, and take that into consideration when considering any dealings with them whatsoever. This person ceased to be the victim as soon as they decided to victimize others for their own personal vendetta. I will not tolerate it. Nobody should. My name has been TotalBiscuit. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.